Hi friends, I am Toshi. Now I am going to say life story of Patrika Narayan, who is the director of Sandeepa chain of restaurants based in a city that simply endorses food in Chennai. She was a proud winner of Indian Chamber of Commerce and FICCI Women Entrepreneur Award. After successful fighting all the odds of failed marriage, addicted husband, and taking care of two kids living in a well-furnished deluxe apartment in Velanchery with a shining luxury car parked outside the door. Whatever happened in Patrika's life, which led to her entry into the world of entrepreneurship, was evidently not a planned one, but was more due to the twice in circumstance that life threw before her. Instead of crimping and living in problems, she successfully transformed her life into a more meaningful and inspirational tale for the world to look back at. Patrika's family consists of her father, who worked in the posts and telegrams department, and her mother in the telephone department. Both are government servants. Along with her two younger siblings, who were based in Santom. Soon she fell in love with a boy who was 13 years older than her and was a Hindu, and decided to marry him. They quickly got married at the register office. They decided that she would finish her college first and then break the news to her parents. But within the 3 months of her marriage, his husband started putting pressure on Patrika to come out with him, and he was constantly threatening her that if she didn't tell her parents about their marriage, then he would, without much of choice, she disclosed the news and faced all the heat from her parents. Soon the news was also spread among her relatives, and the only solution to control the damage was to have the couple socially married. And having said that, the couple took the vows in a Purasavikalam church, after which both the families disconnected ties with them. Hence Patrika moved into a rented house in Annanagar with his husband, only to realize that life was now here close to a Millie's and Boone story, and was just a big blot of disaster. She figured that she had become pregnant by a husband who was heavily into alcohol and drugs, had no money to survive, and had no intention to earn as well. To make this worse, she wasn't able to bring him out of the addiction and got beaten up almost every other day. Now with no money, no earnings, and two small kids, she was left stranded without a roof and had now here to go. That is where her father, who although still never forgave her, but he gave Patrika, her husband, and two children a refuge at his place. Her husband remained sober during the day, but at night would become abusive and brutal if he did not get money to take care of his craving. Luckily, Patrika's father worked night shifts and barely got to see this side of Narayan. But the question of ending still remained unanswered. It was a question of survival for her. It was either surrender to the burden or stand up and fight. And in a lonely battle, she decided to fight. Now, even though cooking and new dishes always caught her interest and passion, But because she came from a family of government servants, the thought of becoming a businesswoman never clicked to her mind. But at the same time, she also did not want to be a burden on her parents. So, as a first to at least make some use of herself, she borrowed a couple of hundred rupees from her mother and started making squashes, jams and pickles at home. Her mother took them to office and sold them to her colleagues. She sold everything that was made in one day itself, which boosted her confidence even more. The income seemed to be ideal to start off with. She valued every penny that she earned, and like a true business person, Patrika invested all that she earned to make more pickles, squeezes and jams. And just about when fate thought she was ready, another opportunity presented itself. During those days, her father friend, who ran a school for handicapped children, was giving out free mobile carts or kiosks to anyone who would employ at least two handicapped people, and a similar deal was offered by them to Patrika as well. And she willingly took it. All she had to do was train the handicapped children to make coffee and serve them to customers. She had seen quite a lot of people crowding in the evening near the Marina Beach where she lived. Hence, she decided to put the mobile cart at the Anna Square on the Marina Beach. But before that, most timing consuming at tedious work was to get the permissions from the public work department, which took up to 1 year. Anyways, finally the big day arrived and she began work on June 21st, 1982. Since the previously night itself, she got the mobile cart rolled out to the beach with the help of the local rickshaw driver. Now, at that time, carts like that of hers sold only tea and cigarettes. But Patrika decided to take the innovative route and included cutlets, samosa, bhaji, fresh juice, coffee and tea on her menu too. To her surprise, on the first day, she sold only one cup of coffee, and that was for 50 paisa. This disheartened her completely. That is when her mother consoled the crying Patrika and said that there is no reason for you to discontinue. At least you sold one cup of coffee. That's a good sign. You will do well tomorrow. And clearly, she was a big hit next day. She sold snacks worth ₹600 to 700. As she started making more money, she also included ice creams, sandwich, french fries and juices too. She never felt scared of the night and made sure that she was personally present and sold all the stuff she made. She had a burning fire within her, which made her keep going, made her believe that she wasn't a failure and that she would also be successful without anyone help. She continued running his cart from 1982 to 2003. She used to be open from 3 p.m. to 11 p.m. every day and later started opening it from 5 a.m. to 9 a.m. for the workers. The minimum she ever made for the cart was ₹25,000 per day. That was during the ban days. This is when the second jump made it was to her. Meanwhile, she unknowingly had turned the spotlight on her, even though she didn't realize, but someone would saw working at the beach. That person was the chairman of the slum clearance board. Seeing her work, she gave Patrika an offer to run the canteen at their office with a popular kitchen and setup. Goes without saying, she accepted the offer, but moreover, she turned it into a huge success. She used to get up at 5 a.m. in the morning, make idols and go to the beach. From 9 a.m. she would be at the canteen, and then from 3:30 p.m. onwards she would again get back to the beach cart like 11 p.m. till 11 p.m. Patrika now had employees to cook, clean and complete every other task, which all together happened at the canteen kitchen. And by now she was also making a decent monthly income of around ₹20,000. Every Wednesday used to be a public grievance day. So about 3,000 people used to come there, and she got thundered business. Her work turned out to be so good that in some time she got another offer to run the Bank of Madurai canteen, wherein she got the opportunity to serve roughly 300 people daily. And with that, she stopped running the canteen at the slum clearance board. Like they say, every problem brings an opportunity with itself. Similarly, Patrika's time was about to change too. One day, after a usual fight with her husband, a frustrated Patrika got into a bus and took a trip till the last stop. Coincidentally, the last stop turned out to be the National Port Management Training School, which was run by the central government. Without a thought further, she entered the premises to meet the administrative officer. During the meeting, she told him that she was a caterer, and she bluffed that she was heated. They were looking for one. And to her surprise, due to problems with the contractor, they in fact were looking for one. Obviously, the genius that she was got the offer. But what was even better was the perks that came along. She now had to serve 3 meals to about 700 students daily, and she also got her own quarters to stay by them, and it was successful from day one. Her first weekly payment was ₹80,000, which soon went on to become ₹1 lakh per week, an amount far more elevated than earlier. By now, she had become a pro at what she did best. She exactly knew how to manage things, run things, and smoothly delegate and execute things effectively. She went on to continue this till 1998. In the year 1998, she was offered a partnership in one of their units by the Sangeeta Restaurant Group. But her son Praveen Rajkumar wanted her to start her own restaurant and build a brand on their own. Just when happiness was beginning to make space, a huge tragedy took place in their life. She lost her daughter Pratibha Sandra and her son-in-law in a road accident a month after they got married in 2004. This shattered Patrika and broke her into pieces. She withdrew herself from all that she was doing. She just wasn't able to get over her daughter's death. What had shocked her even more was the way the accident victims were treated by the ambulance of operators when they found that all the four in the car were dead. They just simply refused to carry the dead bodies. Finally, somebody came forward and carried all the dead bodies in the boot of a car. And when Patricia saw the bodies being taken out of the boot, she just broke down. No human, especially a mother, could bear such a scene. That is when her son decided to take responsibility of everything and started her first restaurant. And started their first restaurant in the loving memory of her daughter Sandeepa in 2006. Although it did take some time for her to make out the shock, but with time she did come back and started helping her son in the business. She also purchased an ambulance and decided to keep it on that every spot. Acharaka Pakkam. To help people, whether the victims are alive or dead. And since then, there has been no looking back for her and her business. Patricia, who began her career into entrepreneurship 30 years ago by selling eateries from a mobile cart on the Marina Beach with just two people and 50 paisa per day, today has more than 200 people working directly under her and makes rupees 2 lakhs per day in sales collectively from 14 outlets of Sandeepa. And with that, her lifestyle has drastically changed too. A woman who once used to travel in a cycle rickshaw, moved into a riding in auto rickshaws, now owns luxury cars. Today, her work experience and life speaks in such loud volumes that she can give chicken soup for the soul a run for its money by writing self-help books on how to survive in spite of being surrounded by hardship. This is the story about Patricia Narayan Caterer. Thank you for watching.